morning and welcome to worship.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Special welcome to those of you joining us on Facebook or who will be watching us on YouTube later. It's a great joy to be able to share this moment of prayer with you. Today is All Souls Day, which means it's the day we remember all our loved ones who have departed this life and now rest in God's hands. Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins and heals all our diseases.
His mercy endures forever. Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our name.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Spirit, come, fill us to overflowing.
Be our guide, Holy Spirit, come.
Spirit, show us your power.
Be our teacher, Holy Spirit. Lead us into all truth, come.
Spirit, be our healer.
Heal us, Holy Spirit, come.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Heal us and make us whole.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
God of peace, you have taught us that in returning at rest we shall be saved. In quietness and confidence shall be our strength. By the might of your Spirit, lift us, we pray, to your presence, where we may be still and know that you are God. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
God, the Maker and Redeemer of all believers, grant to the faithful departed the unsearchable benefits of the Passion of your Son, that on the day of his appearing they may be manifested as your children. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Seated for the reading of Scripture. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-matured wine, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-matured wine strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all people, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll recite together that portion of Psalm 116. In our bulletin.
I kept my faith even when I said, I am greatly afflicted. I said in my consternation, everyone is a liar.
What shall I return to the Lord for all his bounty to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant, a child of your serving maid. You have loosed my bonds. I will offer to you a thanksgiving sacrifice and call on the name of the Lord.
A reading from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. What am I saying, brothers and sisters? What I am saying, brothers and sisters, is this. Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Listen. I'll tell you a mystery. We will not all die, but we will all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable body must be put on imperishability, and this mortal body must put on mortality. When this perishable body puts on imperishability, and this mortal body puts on immortality, then the saying that is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you to stand as you are able for the reading of the Gospel. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Very truly I tell you, anyone who hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life and does not come under judgment, but has passed from death to life. Very truly I tell you, the hour is coming and is now here when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself, and he has given him authority execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated. I don't know what you think, but these are very nice, powerful words, hopeful words, great words for All Saints' Souls Day. They will remember the departed. They are words of hope. They are words of assurance. They are reminders to us that death is not the final word. God is the final word. And God has destined, prepared a place for us that when our time here is ended, we have another place where we live eternally. And Isaiah gives the vision of that, of what it will be when all that is realized. It will be said on that day, lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice. the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. Powerful. Powerful, powerful. The psalmist also gives us a testimony. This is, you probably by now know that I believe, and in this, that Psalms really are very realistic. The psalmist talks about how they feel, but how they feel now is not who they are. They are always ending with the word of hope, because that's their experience. And really that's our experience too, if we are not overwhelmed by the sadness and grief that comes our way. When we look clearly, our lives, yes, have been filled with sad moments, but the bigger picture is that God has continually come through. Listen to what the psalmist says, verse 10. I kept my faith even when I said, I am greatly afflicted. That is the reality. Sometimes we feel overwhelmed and afflicted, but the hope we have is in this faith. And then he concludes, I will offer to you a thanksgiving sacrifice and call on the name of the Lord. That's the way to deal. That's how you deal with the challenges, with the hardships of this life. Calling upon the name of the Lord. Because he is our only Lord. He is the one who will wipe away all those tears. And thank God that we don't have to wait for the very end. Even while we are still here, God comes our way and wipes our tears. What will happen at the end will be that there will be no more tears in this world. God wipes our tears, and then we experience another hardship, and then more tears. Then there will be no more tears. But thank God that even while we are still on the journey, he wipes our tears. And that's really the essence of what we do here every week. We come to God to help us with the strength, with the grace to endure the hardships of our time, believing that one day all will be. Today, as I said, is All Souls Day. And I found some notes on this day. Some people confuse it with All Saints Day. They are closely related, but not quite. So listen to what these notes say. If we have trouble thinking of dear old Auntie Polly or Uncle John as being saints, now is the appropriate time to remember them formally. There are countless departed souls who were faithful Christians, but who could hardly be regarded as exemplary saints. We like to remember them and to give thanks to God publicly for them. This occasion, sometimes called All Souls Day, is a twin feast of All Saints Day. It has been observed in the Eastern Church from very early times and was introduced into Western Europe in the 10th century. The 16th century English reformers cut this festival out of the church year because they did not like to distinguish between All Saints and All Souls. The New Testament makes no such distinction, but rather refers to all Christians as saints, stressing the fact that salvation is a gift from God, and that none of us earns a special place in his kingdom by our good deeds. This is a good time to remember the unspectacular children of God, those whose Christian witness may have been weak or faltering, but who are still very dear and important to God and to us. This is a prayer associated with this. May O God, who has brought us near to an innumerable company of angels and to the spirits of the just, made perfect, grant us during our pilgrimage to abide in their fellowship and to become partakers of their joy. So what we'll do today, we will remember before God those people who are sick, who will bring our prayer, but in the middle of the litany, there will be an opportunity to name before God those for whom we will remember this day, those souls, those holy souls, those saints, with a small S. And even those poor souls, I was reading somewhere else where they said that the reason why the reason they distinguished all saints from all souls was that the saints were those for whom people were very sure that they made it. And the souls, all souls, were those that we are not quite sure. So that, and they were referred to as poor souls in purgatory. So we remember them and prayed them out of purgatory so they could make it too. So it is okay to name even those for whose faith is known to God alone. We actually have a service in our book of occasional services, that is for people whose faith is known to God alone. So if I did one service like that, where somebody had died, and no one was sure whether they were believers or not, whether they were ever baptized or not, and so I used that service of those for whose faith is known to God alone. One would say, whose faith is known to God alone? It's okay. Let us then before God, Lord, for whom we offer our prayers. Lord, this morning we bring before you those who have asked for our prayers. Especially Mary Ann, Ellen, Debbie, Kayla, Rock, Marge, Thomas, Nikki, Leo, Deborah, Liz, all those who are bereaved, all those with COVID-19, the staff and children at our school and at the Sao Paulo Mass Ministry, Frankie, Ethel, Mary, Helen, Roy, Montana, Wayne, Scott, Rod, Trouble, Janet, Cheryl, Barbara, Janet, Ryan, Terry, Janet, Jen, Ren, Daniela, Jeffrey, Rod, Kenneth, Brandy, Jenny, Julie, Barbara, Michael, Robert, Kathy, Mike, and many others. God the Father, your will for all people is health and salvation.
We praise you and thank you, O Lord.
God the Son, you came that you might have life and might have it more abundantly.
We praise you and thank you, O Lord.
God, the Holy Spirit, you make our bodies the temple of your presence.
We praise you and thank you, O Lord.
Holy Trinity, one God, in you we live and move and have our being.
We praise you and thank you, O Lord.
Lord, grant your healing grace to all who are sick, injured, or disabled, that they may be made whole.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Grant to all who seek your guidance, and to all who are lonely, anxious, or despondent, knowledge of your will and an awareness of your presence.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Mend broken relationships, and restore those in emotional distress to soundness of mind and serenity of spirit.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Blessed physician, nurse, and all others who minister to suffering, granting them wisdom and skill, sympathy, and patience.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Grant to the dying peace and the holy death, and uphold by the present consolation of your Holy Spirit, those who are grieving.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Comfort all those who grieve the loss of their loved one, especially in the past year, especially the families of Jim Pratt, Cesar Noble, John, Joanne Steeler, Lee Shoko, Chuck Doyle, Richard Barringer, Nancy Miller, Faith Monroe, Carol Turner, this point in the heart, others that you remember this way. That they may know the peace that comes from you alone.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Restore to wholeness whatever is broken by human sin in our lives, in our parish, in our community, in our nation, and in the world.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
You are the Lord who does wonders.
You have declared your power among the peoples.
With you, O Lord, is the well of life.
And in your light we see light.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Heal us and make us whole.
Almighty God, giver of life and health, send your blessing on all who are sick and upon those who minister to them, that all weakness may be vanquished by the triumph of the risen Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Point, if you wish to be anointed, I invite you to stand.
It's a lot of effort to get into that.
Teaching our Lord Jesus Christ as tenderly with the present. Grant you the inward anointing of the Holy Spirit to drive away all sickness of body and spirit. Renew your strength and grant you victory to enable you to go to love and serve you all the days of your life. In Jesus' name. Sustain with his presence. Grant you the inward anointing of the Holy Spirit. Drive away all sickness of body and spirit, renew your strength, and to grant you victory, which I never yet got to be loving and serving me all the days of your life.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen. Here I lay my hand upon you and anoint you with holy water, of the Father, of the Son, teaching our Lord Jesus Christ as tenderly as you have been, to grant you the inward anointing of the Holy Spirit, to drive away all sickness of body and spirit, to renew your strength, and to grant you victory, which will enable you to continue loving and serving all the days of your life. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
teaching our Lord Jesus Christ has taught you this time. Grant you the inward anointing with the Holy Spirit to drive away all sickness of body and spirit, to renew your strength, and to grant you the joy, which will enable you to continue loving and serving all the days. May the mighty Lord, who is a strong tower to all who put their trust in him, to whom all things in heaven and on earth and on the earth bow and obey, be now and evermore your defense, and make you know that the only name under heaven given for health and salvation is the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
You may be celebrate this Eucharist in thanksgiving to God for all our loved ones who have departed this life and now rest in God's eternal kingdom, but also a intercession on behalf of those who grieve, that God is the source of our comfort, who sustain them through and through, till they are united with their loved ones. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comforts us with the blessed hope of everlasting life. For to your faithful people, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when our mortal body lie in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn, proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. The night was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when I had given thanks to you, O God, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this. Supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen,
Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit, to be for your people, the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours. Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. And as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are going to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them and remember that Christ died for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Amen.
us pray together. Precious Father, we give you praise and thanks for this holy communion of the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the pledge of our redemption, and we pray that it may bring us forgiveness of our sins, strengthen our weakness, and everlasting salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may God the Father bless you, God the Son heal you, God the Holy Spirit give you strength. May God the Holy and Undivided Trinity guard your body, save your soul, and bring you safely to his heavenly country, where he lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Thank you, Father.